By the end of this video, you will know how to make a basic A-line skirt pattern from start to finish in Chloe. You can apply this pattern drafting method onto hand drafting pattern as well as onto Chloe drafting. For example, I'm going to use Chloe software to draft these skirt patterns. You will not require to know Chloe software to learn this simple drafting method. I will walk you through step by step on how to draft these A-line skirt patterns. These include measuring your body, picking the correct avatar size for your skirt, sewing it in Chloe, fitting the skirt onto the avatar, then apply the fabrics onto the skirt, all done in Chloe. Next, I'm going to trace this internal line as a pattern. To do so, I'm going to come over here to the trace tool in Chloe, click one. And then I'm going to click this left dot M, then press down shift on the keyboard and click on this right dot M. And then I'm going to click one more here, right there, and I'm going to press down return enter on the keyboard to turn that baseline into the internal lines. Okay, next I'm going to trace this whole internal shape of a skirt block to a pattern. To do that, while the tracing tool is active, I'm going to just click one on this waistband skirt and then press down shift, click on the side seam. While the shift is pressing down, click one on the hem curve, and finally click one on the center line back skirt. Now I'm going to release the shift on the keyboard and then right click. And as you can see, this option pop up and I'm going to select trace as pattern. Okay, next I'm going to press down shift on the keyboard and left click to place the pattern. After that, I'm going to click one on the page to release that selection. Okay. So there are a few things we need to do on the skirt block. Okay. First, I'm going to delete the point onto this hip line. Okay. To do so, I'm going to come over here to this edit pattern tool, click one, and then hover the mouse to the right. Click on the edit pattern tool and I'm going to come over here, click on that point right there and press down the delete key or backspace on the keyboard to delete. Next, I'm going to click on that internal line and press down shift, click on the next internal line, then the next internal line, and I'm going to release the shift on my keyboard and then right click. And this time I'm going to select extend slash trim and hover my mouse to the right and select two pattern outline. Okay, so let me pan over to the left a little more. Just press down option all on your keyboard and left click to pan this to the left. So after we shorten this internal line, I'm going to turn that line into the baseline. Okay, so while the edit pattern tool is active, I'm going to click one on this first line right here. Next, I'm going to press down shift on the keyboard, then click on the second line, the third line, the fourth line, and also this line right here, and I'm going to release the shift and then right click and select convert to baseline. Okay, as you can see, the line turned to like kind of slight blue dot dot lines, which mean those lines are now baseline. Next, we're going to turn this internal shape into a dot shape. Okay, Right now, right here is just internal line draw into a shape dot onto a pattern, and we want to punch a hole so that hole will turn into a dot. To do so, I'm going to once again, you see right here, my edit pattern tool is active. I'm going to just click one on the left arm dot and then press down shift on the keyboard. And now I'm going to click on this right dot arms, and I'm going to release the shift key and then right click. And I'm going to come down here to cut and sew, okay? Next, I'm going to delete that extra piece. To delete the extra piece, I'm going to come over here to the transform tool, click on one to select, and I'm going to click on that piece and press down delete or backspace on the keyboard to delete.